Microlecture 36, The Cold War. The Cold War originated in the political disputes that happened after the Second World War was over. Joseph Stalin demanded that the Soviet Union control the eastern part of Europe to guarantee military security from Germany. At the time, US President Franklin Delano Roosevelt agreed with Stalin, but his successor, Harry Truman, demanded free elections throughout Eastern Europe, something that Stalin did not want to do. Truman's position was bolstered because, at the end of the war, the only country with nuclear weapons was the US. However, Stalin moved quickly and organized its troops, military occupying Eastern Europe and imposing compliant governments that would buffer against the threat of Western European aggression. These countries were later known as Soviet satellites, nations whose politics and economics were modeled on and dictated by the Soviet Union. Most historians today argue that President Truman misread Soviet occupations as a campaign for world domination. As a consequence, in October of 1945, just a couple of months after the end of the war, Truman issued the Truman Doctrine, which aimed at containing communism to areas already occupied by the Soviet Army by giving material support to governments that in the West view were threatened by communism. In the beginning, the doctrine established by Truman only applied to European countries. Still, quite quickly, those policies also expand to the colonized world, where conflicts emerge associated with the ideological tension between the two superpowers. The first two places where the Truman Doctrine was put in place were Turkey and Greece. These countries received military aid, and not long after, they were a laboratory for the Marshall Plan. The plan, created by Secretary of State George C. Marshall, was an aid package of economic and food aid designed to rebuild Europe, implemented after the Soviet Union supported a coup d'etat in Czechoslovakia. A lasting pattern of escalating reactions to real and perceived provocation was established between the US and the Soviet Union. The Soviets blockade the roads on the Soviet part of occupied Germany, forcing the US to transport things by air to Berlin. The blockade lasts 324 days. In 1949, the United States formed an anti-Soviet military alliance called the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO. Stalin's response was creating the Warsaw Pact in 1955, a formal agreement of several countries allied to the Soviet Union. Europe was then divided in two different armed blocs crossed by an imaginary line called the Iron Curtain. After the Soviet Union developed its own atomic weapons in 1949, they and the United States emerged as superpowers with massive armies, industrial strength, and nuclear arsenals. There was no doubt that they were the most powerful countries on the planet. Both nations got themselves into a military and geopolitical confrontation called the Cold War. At the center of the Cold War was an ideological divide between the United States and the Soviet Union. In the divide, the US saw itself as a defender of the free market, private property, and individual rights. The Soviet Union was the defender of workers, peasants, colonized subjects, and economic development based on central planning and redistribution. The Cold War made the ideological difference between the two countries stronger. Even more, the two superpowers pushed other countries to follow their steps. Had the Cold War been restricted only to Europe, the world's history during the 20th century could have been very different. However, that was not the case, and the Cold War had many other theaters in Asia, Africa, and Latin America. Asia was the first place where the Cold War escalated into a conflict. The Korean War that started in June of 1950 was the earliest direct military showdown between the US and communist forces. It was this war, the event that transformed the Cold War into a global conflict. When the Japanese forces withdrew from Korea after 1945, the country was divided into Soviet and American occupation zones, which in 1948 became communist North Korea and anti-communist South Korea. When the communist force emerged victorious in China in 1949, many people in the US wrongly believed that a worldwide communist conspiracy was on the offensive. In 1950, the Russian-backed Communist Force of North Korea invaded South Korea. The US President Harry Truman sent US troops to lead a UN coalition force to stop what he interpreted as a coordinated communist effort to dominate Asia. The Korean War, 1950-1953, ended in a stalemate with little more than symbolic gains for either side. North Korea conquered most of the peninsula, but South Korea, American and UN troops repelled their foes north close to the Chinese border. At that point, China intervened and pushed back the forces led by the US. In 1953, a truce was negotiated and the fighting stopped. The US wanted to contain communism in Asia but was not willing to fight against the Chinese. French Indochina was another vital geography of the Cold War. With the United States' support, France tried to reimpose imperial rule there after the communist and nationalist guerrilla leader Ho Chi Minh, 1890-1969, declared an independent republic in 1945. The French were defeated in 1954, and the French Indochina gained its independence. Laos and Cambodia became separate states, and Vietnam was temporarily divided into separately governed northern and southern regions. In 1959, a civil war broke between South Vietnam and the Communist Democratic Republic of Vietnam. Cold War fears and US commitment to the ideology of containing drove the United States to get involved in Vietnam. Both President Eisenhower and Kennedy escalated the conflict while refusing to sign the Geneva Accords that temporarily divided the country. In 1964, US President Lyndon Johnson greatly expanded America's role in the Vietnam conflict. He was seeking to, quote, escalate the war sufficiently to break the North Vietnamese will, but not strong enough to risk war with the entire communist bloc. South Vietnam received massive US military aid. The US also extensively bombarded the North. Initially, most Americans supported the war and the struggle against communism, but over time, the public perception of the conflict changed, and a great anti-war movement emerged in the US. By the late 1960s, growing numbers of critics in the US and around the world denounced American involvement in the conflict. In 1968, after the North Tet Offensive, the American public lost all confidence in the US ability to defeat the North Vietnamese. In 1968, President Richard Nixon began a slow withdrawal from Vietnam and finally signed a peace agreement in 1973. Despite all US efforts, in 1975, the North Vietnamese were able to form a unified communist Vietnam. In the late 1960s and 1970s, the United States and the Soviet Union pursued a relaxation of Cold War tensions that became known as, quote, the Tente, because there were no direct confrontations between the two countries. This changed in the 1980s with the invasion of Afghanistan by the Soviets and the presidency of Ronald Reagan, who was decided to confront the Eastern Bloc. The 1980s were the last years of the Cold War, a period of tension that helped define the globalized world geopolitics. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.